Okay, moving on to number 18, paperless agenda management system. Terrell.
Oh, good afternoon, Mayor, or good evening, I guess.
Yeah, it's into the evening now.
Mayor and Council, so this is a subject that's near and dear to my heart, as well as your own. I am coming before you to authorize or to recommend the purchase of tablets and smartphones for the use of City Council and approve a supplemental appropriation to pay for the equipment and a modified recommendation for instead of discontinuing the technology allowance to allow it to be used for any of the council members who choose not to use city equipment but to use their own. So back in the background is in 2010 we were in the midst of the economic downturn, and staff throughout the city was tasked with or challenged with using innovative ideas to save on resources, staff time, and other costs. And so the city clerk's office and IT had got together, and we had seen programs regarding agenda management using different types of tablets and like Nook readers or Kindles. And also they have larger laptops and things that were available through companies like Granicus that were selling agenda management systems. And so Brian Hansen and IT and I got together, and we found the iPad and the what's called iAnnotate and Dropbox, where it goes really easy between council and staff. Previous to using this system, it would take pretty much three staff members 3 days to get the agenda out and processed and printing costs. Now it takes 1.5 plus the departments to do it all agendized. And so printing costs, besides, you know, we'd print 68,000 copies a year for the agenda. Besides the cost of the paper, you have the wear and tear on your copiers. And so at the time, when in 2010, Mr. Buckland was on the council at that time, we had recommended purchasing the equipment at that time to do this process to save, be efficient, save task time, save trees. And it was considered new technology at the time. And so in order to see whether it worked or not, council had elected at that time to purchase their own equipment. Since then, everybody knows that it's 7 years ago. It's very established equipment. And we've basically, for the last 7 years, made our model in administration on providing council with this information through this process. With a new council, I think it's time to and appropriate to bring back the fact that this is how we do business in the city, business forward, and ask that you let us provide you with equipment so that we can provide you with the better service when you for the people who do not have iPads or the people who have different forms of digital access, there's problems. It doesn't all talk to each other that way. The iPad and the smartphones are standard city equipment. If you're had an office at City Hall, the City Hall City will be providing you computer equipment to work with. Anyway, but since you work out and about, I think it's very appropriate that you have a mobile device that you can access city information on. So so that is my recommendation, to purchase the tablets and smartphones for the use by city council members if they so choose, and approve a supplemental appropriation for fiscal year 2017-18 of $3,600 for one-time equipment and software costs, and $2,100 in ongoing monthly cost. That's annual. So, and then for those who choose to use the city equipment, then they would not be eligible for the technology allowance that was being charged or being given to council members, which is only $30 a month, which doesn't really cover most Wi-Fi fees.
Okay. With that, comments from council member?
Yeah, through the mayor. When I came onto the council, this was first being discussed. I was somewhat shocked that I would no longer, after my first council meeting, no longer be receiving a package. I think my first package had 480 some pages in it, that wouldn't be being dropped by staff onto my doorstep at my house any longer, and that I would be able to look at something on an electronic device, flip through it, and access the internet at the very same time to gather more data. We deal with things like assembly bills and other pieces in our daily readings that deal with laws, and we need to become a little bit more familiar with those. So being able to sit down with one device, simply flip through that and gather the information, note up or make notes on your copies through iAnnotate and things like that. It was really mind-boggling. But at that time, the majority of the council adopted that. And as we progressed through time, we only had one council member, and I won't mention Tejman's name out loud and in public, but he was one that resisted the technology. And it was evident that by having it, you could cut down on just your own time in having to chase down and make sure that you had the proper documents for any given meeting. Attending, we all attend various committees, and it's helpful to be able to get all of those electronically. Many of us deal with reading somewhere in the vicinity in any given month of a couple thousand pages of material and reviewing probably many more documents through the various meetings that we might be in. The options, Terrell, that have been given to us through your research and the research with IT have been, I think, instrumental and made it certainly as smooth a transition as you possibly could make it. The equipment recommendations that you have in place, I think, are very fitting to be able to move forward still at a pace where each one of the council members would have access to the equipment that makes our job certainly easier. And as the city begins streamlining into a more technology-driven environment where you can actually now, I think, as of the 1st, pay your permit fees and apply for permits and everything online, it would only be expected, I think, that members of the council have an option for the equipment. I know I'm on my second iPad. The first one just simply wore out, didn't have the same robust features that this one does, and certainly as the technology or the apps become more of a consumer of our the storage space, sometimes those changes have to be made. And I would only recommend that when we look at that equipment, that we certainly look at one of the highest levels of storage, as many of these documents we keep in place for quite some time as reference materials, and be able to go back to that. But the option to be able to continue with a $30 per month for those of us that made an investment years ago and certainly run with our own phones would be the option that I would look at, along with the ability to buy for council members both a pad, an iPad, and smartphone.
Any other comments from council members?
I just want to say I'm all about going paperless, but I'm going to choose to stick with my own only because I will need a tool belt to carry all my electronics. because I work for the state, so I have my separate laptop, my iPad, my iPhone, all from that entity as well. And then I have all my personal stuff, and I do a lot of remote business, and I stay in hotels, and when I go from one meeting to another, I literally have to lug my carry-on because I have to take all my electronics with me for safety and security reasons, and I'm going to choose to stick with my own because we've already kind of figured how my system works with all of that. Otherwise, literally, I'm going to need another carry-on. So I appreciate it very much, though. So.
Anybody else? Well, I will say that I'm the one that actually requested that this to be reconsidered. And for one reason, there are legal cases that are going on right now that are trying to will make, if you have it on your own private devices, that the people will have access to your own information. I know it's, I just don't like that. I mean, I use my computer at home. I use this little tiny thing right here. It works fine for what we're doing here. But I mean, if it was a request act, my computer, whatever is on there, would be available for viewing, although it would be under secure situations. I don't like that. And then the county, they issued their own separate ones a few years ago to where they already provide it. It already is doing that. And then providing the options to keep your own, I think, is the great way to go. Probably eventually as they wear out, then if he's on, might say, hey, city, it's time for you to do this or not. But I feel that it's there should be a separation of government and personal access to the internet. I think it should be completely separated. So with that, I do have a speaker card. James, on it.
Good evening, Mayor Cleveland and council members. As was stated by Terrell and Mr. Buckland, this was brought up before the city council at the October 19th, 2010 meeting. And all the council members, only Mr. Buckland was the one only still here, I should say. And at that meeting, staff wanted to purchase eight $1,500 laptops or tablets for paperless management. And after comment from concerned citizens and the cost and use of this equipment, Mayor Cash Gill made a motion to have city council members, as well as the city manager, the assistant city manager, and the city clerk to purchase their own tablets or laptops so they could use them for personal use as well as city use. As far as I know, it should still be that way. Adding smartphones to the request this time, I don't think should be needed. All council members already have a smartphone, and the added cost of $6,000 per year plus $3,600 for initial purchase of the iPads are not warranted by any kind of cost analysis by whatever paper they think they're going to save. And the council members should already be practicing paperless management as practiced by past city council members and staff. And as per your own city council reference guide, on page 21, it states that equipment and technology with the states the following. With the advancement of technology, council adopted a paperless agenda in 2010 using an in-house automated agenda management process. The city council elected not to have the city provide devices to the staff or council members for this process. Staff is available to council to discuss and assist new council members with the process of device selection. And then the paragraph right under that says, for use of public resources, it states the following. Council members shall not be use public resources such as staff time, equipment, supplies, or facilities for private gain or personal use. So any equipment purchased by the city would be property of the city and only used by city business. An audit or record of purchases would have to be maintained and checked on a regular basis. No personal business could be allowed on these devices. In conclusion, I think the citizens of Yuba City should not have to provide these items to our city council members. the money that would have to be used for these expenses could be used for more urgent expenses like our tourism or pension costs or critical expenses in the coming years. Past council members were able to provide their own phones and tablets or laptops to access the records they needed and still be able to use it for personal use as well. So I think the current council members should be able to do the same thing. Thank you.
James, I understand your approach on this, but I would have to buy a whole new computer setup or figure something out on mine anyway. And I don't think that's a burden that should be put on a council member, myself, or like that. The county made the decision. I followed through with what exactly you said. All business was on that had to be for the county. I did that. So that procedure can be done.
Of a burden. You have to carry around two phones or two tablets.
So what?
That'd be worse for you, huh?
I have a business connected to this one.
Yeah.
And it's my personal and it's a business. I don't want the county or the city to be able to, I don't want to do city business on this. And I've had to. And I don't think it's right that by that choice, I'd be required to do county business or city business on that. It would be required that I do that.
Yes.
To fulfill. I think that's wrong.
It says in your guide.
No, all it says is that I can't do personal business on county stuff.
Correct.
Exactly. And I followed through with that in the past.
Mr. Mayor, just a point of clarification. He's exactly right. It is in the guide. That's why it's back before the council this evening as a policy decision to amend what you read. So everything you read is absolutely correct.
But this is an amendment to that and addressing those conditions.
But you're paying $100 a month for your cell phones for each of you. That's more than I think you should have to pay. I don't pay that much, but I get everything. But I guess that's the city. Money is not an object.
And it's an option. It is not a requirement for them to do that. It's an option.
Okay.
So.
Do you have any other questions for me?
Any other questions, comments? With that, I need motion or yes.
To make the gentleman happy, I'm still just taking a $30 a month technology. Just want to let you know to make you happy. Thank you.
That. Looking for an action.
I would move a recommendation that for those requiring such that we approve the purchase of tablets and smartphones for use by the council. Given the guidelines as indicated in the staff report and approve a supplemental appropriation to cover the costs for those not to exceed $3,600, which is obviously going to be somewhat short of that, and then the ongoing costs of $2,100 annually, which I haven't done the math real quickly, but the $30 a month by at least three members may come up to that cost, and along with the other fees, but then allow the to accept the technology allowance that's currently provided at $30 per month per council members that provide their own smartphone and own tablet.
I'll second it.
Got a motion and a second. If there's no more comment, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Unanimous. And the other comment, like you said, it would definitely be a significantly less and not to exceed. Thank you for including that. Okay. Unanimous vote. Moving on to city council reports. Council member Buckland, what did you
have appointments.
Oh, I'm sorry, number 19.